You can also use your small brush for making simple outlines of leaves. This can be fun next to loose florals and should be experimented with if you like this style. Or you can leave a line in the middle of a leaf in a darker color, or leave white space by painting around it in two strokes like I showed earlier. Notice how I made the leaves end rounded this time instead of pointed by just using my brush differently. If you want to paint more realistic leaves, then get references and try copying them. I recommend to do it loosely and in your own interpretation, but it's up to you how realistic you want to get. With time and experience, you will find some of these were inspired by references and some were made up. Take out a page and play around like I did here. It's up to you if you want to paint stems. You really don't have to, but practicing painting tons of different kinds of leaves to get more comfortable with it and to be more comfortable with your brush is a great way to start this practice. And notice that none of my leaves are perfect and look exactly like the last one. I always use leaves, and I'm interpreting them in my own way and simplifying with loose brush strokes. I add a second color in to leave the white of the page. It makes the piece feel more lately unique. I'm not really looking at the reference anymore, but it's more like I understand how the petals are. So I'm doing something similar and doesn't bleed. And we'll talk about this more a little later. I continue painting the petals until it's done. That was super simple on it. And I start painting thick petals around the center point by pressing my brush down. Because I touch the center, it pulls paint out of it and makes light petals. It's more dark purple into the center this time. And since the paint is still wet, it will bleed out and it will make more contrast because the darks and lights will be very different. I place them randomly and let them bleed into the rose where they touch for a beautiful effect. And that's it. Now this was more like a loose rose shape, but it still works. And notice how I made the leaves as outlines for a nice color. Now that you got the basics down of painting from a reference and studying a flower to understand it, and then you can do it in your own way. That's why observation is just so important. Don't think about it too much, just do one petal at a time. I then drop in some blue to the wet parts to make it more interesting. And this is how loose I am. I leave lots of white space randomly. This is very important. Feel for balance and composition. And I use various colors like blues, greens, and purples, picking them up randomly every time I get more paint, but mostly blue. Sometimes I would drop more waters or inks. I go over this in a couple of my previous classes, but look how playful and fun the
This first one is from Isabel. Actually ordered from Isabel like in the beginning of December. But I don't know, you just assume that like my first order got lost with like the holiday mail and stuff. So when it wasn't here by like the first little bit of January, she was kind enough to send me the same order again, which was really nice of her. So please also check out her stuff. She's really sweet. But this is what I got from her. So, like you saw a little bit earlier, I got another new sketchbook. I got the Arteza mixed media pad. And I did get the 3.5 by 5.5 mixed media mini notebook thing from Arteza recently. And the reason I got this one was, one, I wanted a mixed media pad or like book where I could do watercolor, gouache, use my paint markers, or just like regular sketches on a bigger pad, because my black one, which I do most of my sketches in, like just my regular pencil sketches, that is dry media, and also it's kind of like my ugly sketchbook. So that's a sketchbook where I literally draw whatever I want, and it can be ugly or it can be like the greatest idea in the world, but it doesn't really matter. My smaller one, I kind of want to keep that one for like proper stuff. I have a few things in there that I don't really like that I've done. So I wanted to have something with a bigger canvas that I can do multiple mediums on and kind of use it to test out stuff, but also just to have stuff on a bigger canvas. You know, draw, like paint something nice and maybe turn that into a print or just like put it up on my wall. The smaller one is obviously small, but with this one it's kind of like the middle ground between my two other sketchbooks. It can have some ugly stuff, but it will also have some nice stuff as my skills get better with these different mediums. So right now I'm going to go on Pinterest and find some inspiration, because I really want to paint with gouache today. But I've been having trouble just like getting started because I don't really know what I want to paint. I have a few ideas, but I'm not really committed to them. And obviously I'm still learning gouache, so I want to keep it fairly simple. So I'll go on Pinterest, maybe find some like flowers or maybe like a cartoon landscape or something like that, and then do that. So I think I've decided on this. It's an image from the first Hilda graphic novel of the house. I'll probably simplify it a little bit with the rocks and stuff, but yeah, I think this is simple enough to break in the new sketchbook. So I will be sketching this out and then painting it.